Talking about selfish and talking about entitled, God Almighty, are you following this Lionel Messi stuff? Are you following this Lionel Messi stuff? It's again, this is another instance of like people having their favorites and not willing to criticize their favorites or to call a spade, Messi has essentially decided that he's had enough of playing for Barcelona. He wants to leave. He wants to go seek pastures new. And, you know, that's not a bad thing. I think players, you know, are within their rights to decide they want to go somewhere else and test their talents in another market. And I guess if you're Messi and you're looking at what Ronaldo has done since he's left United and won many other league titles and Champions League medals at other clubs, you look at yourself as Messi and say, you know what, that's one asterisk I got against my name, where I've essentially only played in teams where I've only essentially played in one team where it's essentially catered all around my strengths. So I need to test myself in another league, just at least one, just to give, you know, just to kind of put that debate to bed, if you really want to go down in the history books as the best ever, which I assume Messi would do. So he decides, hey, I want to leave now, especially off the back of, you know, disappointing Champions League exit for Barcelona. But it's just the way it's transpired that's been surprising, right? For somebody that's been so well looked after by Barcelona, right? It's been a pretty good relationship for both. I think, you know, the club has been able to sell, you know, millions of dollars worth of jerseys, maybe closer to billions of his likeness and stuff. And obviously Messi's enjoyed having probably one of the best, you know, well-run, well-supported clubs in the world, right? Being able to showcase his talents in one of the most beautiful stadiums in the world too, in Barcelona Stadium, and just generally being able to be in an environment that's essentially catered towards his strengths, right? Catered towards making him look good, which he don't get. Even some of the top players don't get it, right? Because Zlatan Ibrahimovic, right, he had a bit of a bad spell in Barcelona, mainly due to Messi being there, especially during the Guardiola years. So if anything, you could argue that Messi has run out a lot of players during his time at Barcelona. So it comes to time for him to leave, and now he's demanding to leave for free because of some contract clause that he has that kind of allows him to leave at the last month. What, at the end of each season in July, he's allowed to leave for free if an appropriate offer comes in. Which is insane anyway, he got that worked into his contract. And now they're going through the legal rigmarole of whether or not the end of the season was end of August, whether or not it was the end of July, blah, 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 blah. And now, forget all that stuff, he's refusing to train. He's refusing to take a test. He's refusing to take a COVID test in order to clear for training. And he's refusing to turn up to training. Point blank saying, I'm not going to train. I am not going to train. And it makes you wonder again, like, if this would happen to any other player, if this was something that happened to Paul Pogba and Neymar, even during his time at Barcelona, Neymar got a bit of stick, you know, and he again only went to leave to be his own man at PSG, right? And he was getting stick for that. So I can only imagine if this happened to other players who aren't as well liked, who don't have the, who are not kind of afforded the same luxuries as Messi has, which, you know, I understand in some regards, because he's the best player in the world and will go down in history as maybe one of the best players of his generation. But still, you have to call a spade if you sign a contract knowing full well what the terms were. You can't go turn around and say, hey, I'm not going to play anymore. That's not how it works. And then you've got fans out there saying, oh, they should just let Messi go because he's given them so much over the years. It's like, what kind of business are you guys running that you would allow one of your star assets, a person that's probably going to generate the most income you're ever going to receive from one player ever in your history, just to walk out the door for free? That's not sound business at all, zero. And, you know, if Man City are even considering paying 700 million for him, which is a supposed fee, 700 mil with the option, of course, to then send him or then kind of take him in. It'll be, I think they said it through Duncan Castles, where the City group will buy him, which would then mean if he spends 2 to 3 years at Man City, he'll automatically then get sold or kind of loaned out, or basically his registration will get passed over to the other team they have in the MLS, which would then go out to kind of ride out his career in America, you know, in full glory as much as he deserves to. But the way he's gone about it has been really bad, really, really bad. And it kind of paints Messi in a completely different light. You'd never really expect to see him this way. You wouldn't think he'd kind of treat the team that essentially, you know, took him out of the ghetto in Argentina, paid for his medical bills and supported his entire family during a very pivotal moment in his life. And now he's suddenly, you know, turning around and saying, hey, which he has a reason to, you know, I'm sure he's got his reasons where he says promises haven't been fulfilled, objectives haven't been met, bloody blah, 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 blah. But his influence, if you look at it from a Barcelona side, is obviously way has gone way too far. They probably do need to rein it in some way, shape or form, and this might be the best time to do it. It's just, you know, having to meet that asking price of 700 mil is just nuts. And if you're Man City, is that really worth it? Paying 700 million for Messi at the age of what, 32, 33 for 2 years? That doesn't seem like sound business sense to me. And again, it's not like you're paying, you know, 200 million for him, 300, 400, 700 mil. It's just nuts. Unless this makes me also think that there might just be that much value in a player of somebody as Messi's quality and obvious talent and obviously his brand appeal. They could actually justify, you know, that if they spent 700 million on Messi, that they would get that money back. They could legitimately justify that. And if that's true, it makes you wonder, like, are players getting underpaid? Especially the big ones. Are they really getting underpaid? Especially the ones that don't have any, who don't get paid on the back end, you know, who don't have image rights or who don't get paid a proportion of their jersey sales. They might be getting shagged, you know, if that's the case. If people can justify paying 700 million for Messi for 2 years, definitely football players get underpaid, for sure. It's considering what they bring in, right? Of course, people will say, hey, without the clubs, the players would exist. But some of these clubs, without the players, no one would give a shit. And Barcelona could probably legitimately think, you know what? If Messi leaves, who's going to be watching us? Like, internationally, not their own fan base. I'm sure they'll still be there. But internationally, you know, part of the appeal is seeing these sort of maverick talents playing for those clubs. You only have to look at their history of Barcelona to see, you know, from Ronaldo onwards, the amount of brilliant players, even before that, right, with the Cruyffs and whatever they may be. Like, they need a star marquee person, and especially in this era of football. Does that person exist at the moment? Does that next Neymar, Messi, Ronaldo, does that player even exist? I'm not too sure if they do. So it's a big risk on both sides, but I think if Messi's kind of throwing his toys at the Prem in this way, refusing to train, refusing to take any tests, Barcelona owe it to themselves to be like, you know what, let's just cut our losses and move on, because this is, like, ridiculous. And anyone suggesting that Barcelona should let him go for free, you are smoking crack, mate. No way they should do that at all. No way whatsoever, in my opinion.